Hello and welcome back to another episode of Tash Teaches. I'm Tash, and in today's video I'd like to share with you yet another chance-based melodic machine, this time using delays in conjunction with the chance modules to sort of extend along a melody down a chord sequence. So without further ado, let's jump right in.
First thing I'm going to do is load up a few sine waves. I think six will be enough for our purpose now. So I'm going to get 3, 4, 5, 6. Cool. So we'll have six notes in our chord. This top one I'm going to move up a little bit. I'll show you why in a sec. And I'd also like to now spell out on these six a nice chord. So I think we'll go for C major 9 with the seventh. So not an add. And the way that I'm going to do that is by using the pitch module. So I'm going to start with a C, and then let's do an E. In you go. And then we'll do a G. Nice. And then we'll do a B. And then we'll do a D. And instead of then doing an F, which would sound horrible, I'm just going to do the third again. So we'll do another E. And that should be it for now. So we've got our six voices here. What I'm then going to do is take a Gates module. And we're going to use a Gates module for now, just because we could use a variety of things for this. But first of all, I'm going to now take a trigger. And I'm going to take another trigger. And then I'm going to duplicate these down, so that we've got six triggers. And the point of why I'm doing this is I want to be able to have this one trigger the first, this one trigger the second, this the third, this the fourth, this the fifth, this and the sixth. But as the triggers flow on, I want them to die off in the probability that they will play. So we're going to get a lot more happening on this than we will on this, because this will have had to pass through various chance-based little moments. I'm going to take the Gates output, and I'm going to put that into this trigger, and I'm then going to take a chance. So straight away we have a possibility that this won't trigger. Let's also just get a couple of envelopes so we can actually hear what we're doing in a second. It might just be easier to do this. There we go. And let's just take an audio out, do our classic mixer situation. Nice, nice, nice. Don't know why that happened. Okay, cool. So currently, let's just turn these down as well. There's something about the number minus 10 that just... it's very satisfying. So I'm going to take the chance output here and I'm going to patch that into the gate input. So if we now listen, we're getting a 50% chance that that envelope triggers. Seeing as this is the first voice, I want this to be a little higher. So I'm going to put this to maybe 75. So 75% of the time we're getting a note. So after this, I now want that to not just go to this envelope, but I want it to continue on to the path of this next trigger. We're going to take another chance module, and for now let's leave it at 75 as well, and I'm going to plug that into the chance module. So now we have a note coming through here that 75% of the time will be sent here. Of those 75% of the time, 75% of those notes will trigger this second. So let's have a listen to that. Now that's nice, but what I'd really like to do is to delay this so that they're not necessarily always happening on the same time. So I'm going to use a long delay, and I'm going to just take a long delay and pop it in between the trigger and the chance. I could put it after that, and I'm going to set this to 16th notes for now. Cool. So now let's take the output of that as well and put that into this trigger. We're going to take another long delay, and we're going to make it now 2. So we're going to make it quarter notes. Now we can take another chance module and patch that into here and use that to control this gate. And now let's take the output of that and put it into here. We'll take another delay, and we'll set it to now 3 and patch that into there. make sure that everything is actually going through. No, that's supposed to be coming from here. And let's take another chance module and patch that into there. And we can use this to trigger that envelope. Now let's take the output of that, put it into this trigger, and let's do the long delay again. Another chance-based situation. We'll go for 75% here. We use that to control this envelope. And we'll also go into here. And we've got 2, 3, we'll go for 4, and we'll go for 5 here. So not only are these going to be less likely to happen, but the chances of them happening will be pushed back. And let's take the output of that and put that into here. Now let's have a quick listen to what we've got. And what's quite nice by having these delays is it means that those moments, when I stop it, you'll see from the beginning, we may not have many notes. But after a while, it tends to just find its rhythm and it sounds really quite lovely. Very cool. Now, what I would also like is for there to be some sort of chance that we'll get notes up an octave. So I'm also going to take, after these, a chance module again, and I'm now going to patch the output of that into this chance module, and we'll take a modulator out, and I'm going to attach this, so 50% of the time, to push the pitch up an octave on here. But you'll see that this rather weird little like blah, blah, happening, and that's because it's just bursting through like a trigger length. So what we need to do is take a sample and hold module. So we're going to be holding the value. If it's up an octave and it hasn't then re-triggered, it will wait until the next note. So we're going to take the same output and put that into here. Cool, now let's copy and paste this across over here. So we've got the same outputs. And we can use this one to control the second pitch. So let's go here and do it up 12. We can bring the chances down on this a bit. So 25% of the time, it's going to make it go up an octave. Now let's copy and paste this down here. And we'll do the same thing again, remembering to take the chance output rather than the trigger output. I'm just going to move this over so it looks a bit more equal. So paste that over there. We now need to make this do the third one. So let's do 12. And now let's make this do the fourth one. And we've just got the last two. Oh, I've done the wrong one. There we go. And that. I don't know why in the latest versions of Bitwig, it seems like when you now click on a modulator, let me just do that. When I now click on this, it used to give me the value straight away. Now I've got to actually go back on the modulator to click on it. Okay, cool. So we've now got some sort of like free-flowing sounds that sound rather wonderful. We could put a little bit of delay on it, just for good time's sake. Okay, lovely. What might also be quite nice is to stagger the volumes of these. So maybe we want those high notes to be a little quieter. So I'm going to put that to maybe -5. We'll go for -6, -7, Oh, actually, no, what am I doing? I've done it the opposite way. So in fact, what I meant was -15, -14, -13, -12, and -11. Now that's already sounding lovely. I'm very happy with that. We could go in and change some of these envelopes, and I will do that in a sec. But the first thing I'd like to do is also explore the idea of having even a bit more motion in here. And the way that I'm going to do that is by using this chord that we've got. I'm going to move this up here for a sec, and this is why I moved it away earlier. And I'm just going to copy and paste all of the notes in the chord. So now I need a B, D, and an E. I could have copied all of them at once, I think. Cool. And we're going to do our classic, which is just arpeggiating through the chord. So while this is going to be arpeggiating itself, let's set this to 6, it's also then going to be on the first layer, this special little teacher's pet of a synth. This is also going to be cycling through. So let's take our counter and set this to 6. And remember to set this to wrap. And now, in theory, if I take this same output from here and pop this into here, we're going to be cycling through these notes too. We make this a bit longer. And we could even bring the chants down in here a little bit and start to see what happens if we break down the chances even. It's a 50% chance everywhere that things will continue. Maybe put this up to 65. So we've now got these lovely patterns coming through, and what might be quite nice as well now is to sort of play around with some of the envelopes of these notes themselves. In fact, I am going to bring this back up to sort of 75, because it did seem like quite a good ratio of notes to no notes. Really lovely. And what we could also do is take, say, a select module and take a counter and make this 3. And we'll then use the counter to, let's select a sample and hold. That's not doing what I was thinking it was going to do. We're going to use this then to change whether or not... No, in fact, forget that for now. This is, I'm actually quite happy with this. I think this is really fun. Why don't we also now take another chance module, and we're going to take the output of this guy, and let's do 3 of them. And we're going to take a modulator, and a modulator, and a modulator, and a modulator, and we're going to use these 3 to decide whether or not this first one will give us an octave above on this guy, and also on this guy. So let's select both of them on 12. This will give us an octave on this one and this one. And finally, we're going to take number 3 and number 6. So let's see, 12 and 12. We've got some good numbers. Okay, cool. So let's have a quick listen now. We can bring the percentages down on here as well. Really cool. We could, of course, do a bit of lag. We love our lag, don't we? Let's take another chance module up here, and we'll use this to give us a different values on the lag. Sounds quite cool. Let's use the output of here, actually, rather than... Change that chance to a dice. Sounds really lovely. Why don't we, for old time's sake, bring our trusty kick in. And let's have a quick play around to see what this sounds like in context with something. I'm thinking this might be quite a nice thing to have sort of over a droning bass. In fact, let's use the polysynth. And obviously we're in C. So let's that's just... Oh, I'm really liking that. Yeah, that's very cool. Okay, so what I'm also noticing here is it might be quite nice to be able to alternate between this being a C major and also then potentially going to an A minor. So let's take an LFO and we'll set this to square wave. And we're going to have to, after, let's say, two bars... We want to, for this to start up. Okay, so in fact we need to. No, this is all right. Okay, so we've got a C E G B D and E. We want an A C E G. B. Let me have a look. A C E G. B. Okay, so we just need the G to change. No, I think, okay, no, that could be all right. Let's see what happens if we modulate the G up to an A. So we're going to go up to, and down here we want to change the G to an A. G to an A. So two and two. And let's see what happens. We can pop this. Where are the notes? C. Let's try the C now. Let's have a quick listen to what we got then. Going a bit too insane on that lag, I think. Stop bringing up some of these chances a bit more. Quite lovely, and you can imagine again if you start using this method up here for the individual notes, you're going to get some really exciting things happening. Which note is there? Ooh, really cool. Let's take a lag module here as well, so when the pitch is actually changing. Ooh, really nice.
Well folks, that's sadly all we have time for today, but I do hope that this video has been useful. If you enjoyed it, then please remember to like and subscribe, and smash that notifications button if you'd like to keep up to date with all of my future videos. I'm also a Bitwig certified trainer in case anyone would like some one-to-one tuition. And if you'd like to take your support a step further, then please consider becoming a patron too. In the meantime, happy Monday and happy creating.